A very good evening. You're watching the 11 o'clock news live from Bahrain International with me, Danielle DePorto. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa ratified and issued Law 6 of 2017. The first article ratifies the Arab Anti-Corruption Convention, which was signed in Cairo on the 21st of December 2012. The second article dictates that His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and ministers implement this law, which will take effect the day following its publication in the official press. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, on the occasion of the 16th anniversary of the National Action Charter. In the cable, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister said that the National Action Charter came as a result of the wisdom and vision of His Majesty for the Kingdom's progress and development, to meet the aspirations of the people of Bahrain. His Royal Highness wished His Majesty abundant health and happiness to continue the development march. In response, His Majesty the King sent a cable of thanks to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister. In the cable, His Majesty made reference to the achievements and highlighted the constructive role and experience of the Prime Minister in meeting the aspirations of the people of Bahrain in terms of freedom, democracy and economic development. His Majesty the King wished His Royal Highness the Prime Minister abundant health and happiness. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, marking the 16th anniversary of the adoption of the National Action Charter. His Royal Highness affirmed that the National Action Charter represents an important stage for further national achievements in the modern history of the Kingdom. He stated that the national values embedded in the National Action Charter preserve the supreme interest of the country and continue development towards a future where all citizens participate in its formation. His Royal Highness pledged to implement His Majesty's directives, wishing him abundant health and happiness. In response, His Majesty the King expressed pride in past achievements and hopes of achieving more to make the Kingdom a model in dealing with challenges. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from the wife of His Majesty the King, President of the Supreme Council for Women, the SCW, Her Royal Highness Princess Abicha bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, on the occasion of the 16th anniversary of the National Action Charter. In her cable, Her Royal Highness Princess Abicha emphasized the role and status of Bahraini women in establishing the future of Bahrain, which coincides with declaring Manama as the Arab woman capital, affirming Arab unanimity regarding the high status of Bahraini women. She expressed pride in Bahraini women reaching a new level of achievement and hailed His Majesty's support in making Bahrain a model for women's empowerment. In response, His Majesty the King sent a cable of thanks to Her Royal Highness Princess Abicha, highlighting Her Royal Highness's role in leading Bahraini women in the development, social and economic fields and all of their achievements. His Majesty wished Her Royal Highness abundant health and success. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa visited today the President of the Republic of Turkey, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, at his residence. The two sides discussed the brotherly relations between their countries and means of developing them in ways that would achieve mutual benefits. An agreement was made for Turkey to send architects and engineers to the kingdom to build a grand mosque which reflects the cultural Islamic heritage of Turkey. They also discussed the current regional challenges and ways of overcoming them. After that, His Majesty the King accompanied President Erdogan in an official parade to Bahrain National Airport, where His Majesty bid the Turkish President farewell at the end of his official visit to the kingdom. Also present were His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. We'll be right back. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, received a cable of congratulations from His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, marking the 16th anniversary of the adoption of the National Action Charter. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince expressed aspirations to benefit the country and citizens, hailing His Royal Highness the Prime Minister's efforts to achieve these goals, wishing him abundant health. In response, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister sent a similar cable to His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, in which he hailed His Royal Highness's efforts and support to the development march in the kingdom, wishing him abundant health and happiness. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, met with Turkey's President, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, at his residence in Bahrain. The two sides discussed ways to reinforce cooperation at the level of politics, military, economy and culture. They also asserted the importance of developing cooperation in new fields, including information technology, education, health and tourism, amongst others. Their Royal Highnesses and the Turkish President affirmed the need to strengthen GCC-Turkish cooperation and coordination through strategic meetings in order to reach a free trade agreement between the GCC and member states and Turkey. They also agreed on increasing cooperation at the level of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation to develop economic cooperation amongst Islamic countries. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince stressed the importance of implementing the agreements that were approved during the Turkish President's visit and his discussions with His Majesty the King by the Joint Cooperation Committee. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister expressed pride that President Erdogan started his visit to the region with Bahrain, the chairman of the current GCC summit, which reflects the strong brotherly relations between the two countries. His Royal Highness valued the visit in light of the political, economic and security challenges in the region and stressed the importance of GCC-Turkish partnership in facing them. For his part, the Turkish President expressed pleasure in visiting Bahrain, recalling with appreciation his honourable stances with Turkey, especially in the field after the failed coup attempt. He also expressed his wishes of further development for the Bahraini-Turkish cooperation. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister received today the President of the Republic of Turkey, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, at Gudebiye Palace, in the presence of Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister welcomed President Erdogan, affirming that the kingdom takes pride in his visit. He noted that the visit will support the historic relations between the two countries and will enhance cooperation and coordination in various fields. His Royal Highness noticed the historic status of Turkey for Arabs and Muslims, highlighting the mutual historic and cultural bonds between the two countries. He hailed the Republic of Turkey for being a model in progress, tradition and heritage, and for being a model of Islamic moderation. His Royal Highness hosted a lunch banquet in the honour of Turkish President, in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, a number of royal family members and a number of senior officials and ambassadors of GCC countries in the kingdom. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, met at Gudabiya Palace today with His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The meeting highlighted the achievements made under the vision of His Majesty the King in all sectors. They confirmed that accomplishments in the developmental, legal and political fields push everyone forward to work harder to achieve the government's ambition of prosperity for the country and its people. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince recalled the anniversary of the National Action Charter, which represents a public day of unity in responding to a royal that will be made the citizen the heart of development and an essential partner in the political process. They asserted that the anniversary will remain a bright memory in history, which has laid down the foundations for the development of national progress. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, chaired today at Gudabiya Palace the weekly cabinet meeting in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The Premier congratulated His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa on the 16th anniversary of the National Action Charter. He affirmed that it marks the beginning of the National Development March led by His Majesty the King. He added that the National Action Charter embodies the unity of the people of Bahrain and their support to the leadership. The Prime Minister lauded the visit of the President of the Republic of Turkey, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, and his talks with His Majesty the King, as well as the agreements made between the two countries during his visit. He noted the importance of the visit in terms of its goals, timing, and bilateral as well as GCC results. He added that the visit launches a joint Bahraini-Turkish strategic policy of cooperation on the levels of politics, economy and defence, as well as other fields. Furthermore, His Royal Highness praised the hosting of the World Arabian Horse Organization WAHU conference under the royal patronage of His Majesty the King. He highlighted that the organization's goals are in line with the kingdom's, which is to preserve the pure breed of Arabian horses. He then directed the promotion of national industries and providing incentives to attract local and foreign investment to create more job opportunities for Bahrainis. He also urged the encouragement of small and medium enterprises. His Royal Highness lauded the role of exhibitions in supporting this strategy, including the Gulf Industry Exhibition, which His Royal Highness the Prime Minister patronised recently. He stated that the development of Bahraini employees and their capabilities is a key goal of the government. He also congratulated Her Royal Highness, wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council of Women, Princess Habibah bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, for receiving the Arab Woman Medal, granted to Her Royal Highness from the Arab League, in appreciation of her contribution and support of Arab women's empowerment. He also hailed declaring Manama as the capital of Arab women for the year 2017, which reflects the achievements of the kingdom in empowering women. He commended the role of security bodies and the cooperation between various agencies, which resulted in the success of the recent security operation. His Royal Highness also praised the supporting of patriotic stances of the citizens and directed to tighten the security gap to thwart any terrorist acts. His Royal Highness directed to meet the medical needs of citizens in all government medical facilities and also directed to fill any shortage at all medical departments, including the emergency room at Salmania Medical Complex. The Cabinet reviewed the suggested areas of cooperation with the Republic of Turkey, which will be discussed in the next session of the Bahraini-Turkish Joint Committee. The areas of cooperation include finance and banking, housing and infrastructure, science, technology and industry, tourism, education, health and sports. The Cabinet reviewed the Kingdom's participation in the five national conventions and treaties, which reflects the Kingdom's commitment to the international community. Bahrain has joined the Outer Space Treaty, the Agreement on the Rescue of Astronauts, the return of astronauts and the return of objects launched into outer space, the Convention on International Liability for Damage Caused by Space Objects, Convention on Registration of Objects Launched into Outer Space, Agreement Governing the Activities of the States on the Moon and Other Celestial Bodies. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, affirmed that the National Action Charter is regarded a historic moment in renewing allegiance to the loyalty of the Kingdom of Bahrain and an opportunity of strengthening the values of patriotism. He continued to state that the National Action Charter anniversary is a day of deep appreciation to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa for his initiative, which was met with a national consensus that embodies the will of the people to work for a prosperous Bahrain. In this regard, His Highness Sheikh Nasser recalled the positive participation of Bahraini citizens to vote on the National Action Charter that founded a launching point towards cooperation and solidarity amongst the people, which was inspired by the wise leadership to exert all efforts for the benefit of the country. His Highness Sheikh Nasser also pointed to the advanced role of the National Action Charter in elevating the Bahraini youths as part of His Majesty the King's vision that aims to bolster the youth's role in the build-up of the kingdom. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, today chaired the Bahrain Olympic Committee's Board of Directors meeting. His Highness congratulated the wise leadership on the 16th anniversary of the National Action Charter, wishing Bahrain further prosperity and progress. He also commended the support given by the wise leadership to the sports sector, which contributed to making historic achievements last year, noting the success of National Sports Day, which focused on raising Bahraini society's awareness of the importance of sports. In this regard, Sheikh Nasser expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, for his support to the youths and sporting sector in general, and National Sports Day in particular. He also expressed thanks to all companies and private sector organisations that supported the activities of the event. His Highness praised the outstanding media coverage of National Sports Day in various media outlets inside and outside of Bahrain. The Board of Directors then discussed administrative and financial issues. His Highness Sheikh Nasser directed the executive management to prepare a study for the privatisation of and commission of some departments and to form a committee for marketing the Olympic Committee programmes, headed by the board member Mohammed Isa Al-Rifai. Bahrain Defence Force Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al-Khalifa met today with the Chief of Staff of the Turkish Armed Forces, General Hulusi Akar, and his accompanying delegation, in the presence of the Minister of Defence Affairs, Lieutenant General Yusuf bin Ahmed Al-Jalahma, and the BDF Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Dia bin Sakhra Al-Noemi. The Commander-in-Chief welcomed the guests, hailing the friendly ties between the Kingdom and Turkey. He noted the cooperation between the two countries in various fields and methods of enhancing joint work. At the end of the meeting, commemorative gifts were exchanged. The closing ceremony of the 2017 Tennis Championships was conducted today under the patronage of BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa. The event was attended by a number of BDF's senior officers. The Commander-in-Chief of the BDF deputised the Minister of Oil, Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, to attend the event, which coincides with the 49th anniversary of Bahrain Defence Force. The tournament, held at the BDF Officers Club, began on February 1st with a large participation of officers from various security agencies. The championship aims to bring out the best tennis players in the kingdom, in addition to creating an atmosphere of fraternity and networking. The ceremony commenced with the recital of verses from the Holy Quran, followed by a welcome speech delivered by Brigadier Mohammed Al-Khatter. The Minister of Oil congratulated the participants of the tournament for their outstanding performance and expressed his thanks to the organisers for the excellent competition. He also affirmed that holding events is an embodiment of the importance of physical fitness, a vital military requirement. At the end of the ceremony, Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa crowned the winning teams and players of the tennis championship. The International Peace Institute, IPI, held a seminar under the theme Turkey's Perspective of Peace in the Middle East, with the participation of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa. The guest of honour and main speaker was His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Turkey, Mr. Recep Tayyip Erdogan. President Erdogan emphasised the need to take further responsibility in helping countries in crisis through exerting greater efforts. He added that this will be achieved through cooperation with the GCC and other regional countries that are ready to help.
As Turkey, we give utmost importance to our relations with Bahrain and also our relations with the Gulf countries. That's why President Erdogan wanted to pay this visit, and we are starting with Bahrain, then we will go to Saudi Arabia and Qatar. And we never forget His Majesty King of Bahrain's visit to Istanbul, Ankara in Istanbul, soon after the attempted coup, and we officially opened the third bridge on Bosporus. And that visit was also very successful. And Foreign Minister Khaled is like my brother, my elder brother, and he was helping me a lot since I was appointed as Foreign Minister. He's more experienced, and we have been working hard to further deepen our cooperation with Bahrain and also for with the region. And the last GCC Turkey meeting in Riyadh was very successful, and now Bahrain is chairing the GCC, and inshallah during the this chairmanship we will make more achievements in our relations. And so political relations excellent. We are ready to increase bilateral trade volume and the economic cooperation, more investment both in Turkey also in Bahrain. Many Turkish businessmen are so much interested in doing business in Bahrain, also doing business with businessmen from Bahrain in third countries, in Turkey, here in Bahrain. So alhamdulillah, very successful visit so far. Yesterday we signed 4 agreements and we will follow up, we will implement them. And yesterday's meeting was very successful. We look forward having today's meeting before we leave, and we are very, very happy to be here, and we always enjoy the great hospitality of Bahrain and Bahraini people, and we feel here at home. Believe me, we feel here at home.
The Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan, accompanied by the Minister of Foreign Affairs, President of the Mission of Honour, Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, visited Al Fateh Grand Mosque. At their reception was the Minister of Justice, Sheikh Khaled bin Ali Al Khalifa, and the Undersecretary of the Ministry, Farid Ibrahim Al Mufta, as well as the Governor of the capital, Sheikh Hisham bin Abdurrahman Al Khalifa. They performed Al-Asr prayer at the mosque and then toured its departments. After that, the Turkish President and the Minister of Interior visited Beit al-Quran and were received by Dr. Abdullatif Kanu and the capital governor. The Turkish President toured the Islamic building.
Thank you.
The president of the High Organizing Committee of the World Arabian Horse Organization, WAHU, Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, thanked His Majesty the King for his patronage of the conference, which affirms His Majesty's interest in the organization's goals. Sheikh Isa highlighted the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince for the conference and his attendance of its opening ceremony, which emphasizes his interest in horses that are part of the kingdom's culture and history. He noted the success of the kingdom's hosting of the conference, which marks a new achievement in the field of hosting conferences and meetings. He hailed the role of the organization's president, Peter Pond, and the members of the Executive Committee and General Assembly in developing the organization, affirming the conference's results in the kingdom. He thanked the organizing committee and all the staff and volunteers in the conference for contributing to its success. With an invitation from the Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, BACA President, Sheikh Hamad bint Mohammed Al Khalifa, and within the framework of the activities of tourism promotion in the Kingdom of Bahrain, and the utilization of the large number of participant countries in the World Arabian Horse Organization, WAHU, held under the patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Authority for Culture and Antiquities received the delegation's representatives in Bahrain National Museum, where they were acquainted with Bahrain's heritage as well as many cultural landmarks. The Culture and Arts Director, Sheikh Ahala bint Mohammed Al Khalifa, was at the forefront of the reception, where she welcomed the guests in their second country, Bahrain, hailing their efforts shown in the Global Conference for Purebred Arabian Horses. The guests toured the museum to learn about its inclusion of tourism pillars, where it holds a rich collection of ancient archaeological artifacts from Bahrain, acquired since 1988, covering 6,000 years of Bahrain's history. The participants also listened to a detailed explanation about the museum's most important halls, the Natural History Hall, that focuses on Bahrain's natural environment, which contains samples of plants and animals found in Bahrain, and they were briefed about the exhibits and the departments of ancient history. The participants took a commemorative photograph with the Quran and ancient astronomy manuscripts, and the historical documents and letters in the Documents and Manuscripts Hall. The stables of His Royal Highness Mohammed bin Salman Al Khalifa, may his soul rest in peace, hosted a show of purebred Arabian horses in the framework of the World Arabian Horse Organization WAHU Conference for 2017. Present were His Highness Sheikh Salman bin Hamad bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Mohammed bin Salman Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Nader bin Mohammed bin Salman Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Nuh bin Mohammed bin Salman Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Ali bin Mohammed bin Salman Al Khalifa, the President of WAHU, Mr. Peter Bond, and a number of the organizing committee's members. At the beginning of the ceremony, His Highness Sheikh Salman bin Hamad bin Mohammed gave a speech welcoming the WAHU president and members, hailing their efforts in enhancing the work of the organization and to cooperate to preserve the purebred Arabian horses around the world. A show was held during the ceremony of the stable's purebred Arabian and rare horses. The Secretary General of the Supreme Council for Women, accompanied by the wife of the Turkish President, Amina Erdogan, and her accompanying delegation on a number of visits to a number of projects' tourism facilities. The tour began with visiting Abdullah bin Yusuf Fakro Social Centre in Isatown. Amina Erdogan was briefed on the services and programmes of the centre, including social services, family counselling, family development programmes, and development programmes for children. The wife of the Turkish president also visited the Island Farms, a project that won Best Agricultural Project Award, followed by a visit to Beit al-Quran. She also visited Manama Souk and witnessed the development of traditional projects, crafts and Bahraini heritage. In celebration of the 16th anniversary of the National Action Charter, the seminar Loyalty to Bahrain, the Experience of Expatriates, organized by the ISA Cultural Center, was held today to highlight the experience of expatriates of all nationalities in Bahrain. Heba Abdulghafar was there and delivers more reports in this.
The seminar Loyalty to Bahrain, the Experience of Expatriates was held today at the ISA Cultural Center to highlight their experience based for generations on peace, harmony and tolerance, creating a truly diverse social fabric. The event was in celebration of the 16th anniversary of the National Action Charter, a cultural and social watershed of the citizens of Bahrain, when 98.4% of the citizens voted for democracy. ISA Cultural Center Vice Chairman of the Board of Trustees and Executive Director, Dr. Sheikh Khalid bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, has reflected the warm welcome of Bahrain to expatriates.
We have chosen more than 26 nationalities to speak from different profession, different ages, different countries, different backgrounds and different ages. So that we can have a full picture of how the expatriates are living here in Bahrain.
Secretary General of the Bahrain Federation of Expatriates Associations, Ms. Betsy, spoke about their general feedback.
We have learned so much from our Bahraini brothers and sisters about an inclusive, diverse, multicultural society where from the moment you arrive in Bahrain, you're no longer a stranger. We're all Bahrainis here.
Diverse expatriates united considering Bahrain their home shared the stage to narrate their personal experiences about Bahrain. Dr. Amir Al-Sidi, one of the expatriate speakers, expressed his gratitude.
The safety. No discrimination. The people, they are friendly, they are kindly. And also, you found the order everywhere. So I can say this state, it is a state of law.
The event was really warm and delightful. No wonder that Bahrain expatriates reached 1.42 million, representing 54% of the population. Bahrain is leading the whole Arab world as the destination most favored by expatriates, ranked the 19th in a global survey of expatriate living by Expat Insider in 2016.
The Loyalty to Bahrain Symposium reinforces Bahrain's willingness to enhance cultural exchange and dialogue by always being a home to expatriates from all over the world. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Heba Abdulghafar.
The American Chamber of Commerce is gearing up for hosting the MENA Regional Council Forum, which this year focuses on SMEs, unlocking economic potential. More in this report with Yasmin Ibrahim.
The American Chamber of Commerce Bahrain will be hosting this year's AmCham MENA Regional Council's annual forum and held a press conference today with an opening speech from the president of AmCham Bahrain, Mr. Qais Zoubi, to officially launch the forum.
We are concentrating on developing SMEs and unfolding economic potentials for SMEs. And as a result, we are hoping to have a good group of participants and speakers. And we are very thankful also for the EDB, for the Tamkeen, the Ministry of Commerce and industry and tourism, as well as the Bahrain Chamber of Commerce, for giving them their full support.
The forum intends to promote the expansion of trade and investment between the markets of the MENA region and the US, and will focus this year on SMEs, unlocking economic potential.
Every 2 years, one of the chapters is the chair for the AmCham MENA. We are very proud that Bahrain was the chair last year and we are the chair this year. So we thought, why don't we do a proper forum that will position Bahrain to the world, that we are really the hub for different things. So we're hosting this forum. We're expecting lots of delegates to come from the Gulf region, from the MENA, and from the United States. We're trying to promote the intra-trade between these countries and at the same time with the U.S. We want to encourage Bahrainis to be part of this, the Bahraini SMEs, the startups. It's a good way to network and to build relation with different sectors, whether it's industrial, whether it's financial, it's tourism. So it's an excellent opportunity for SMEs in the region, but a big focus for Bahrain.
AmCham is very excited about having the honor of hosting this, the AmCham MENA Forum here in Bahrain. And we see this as a particularly great opportunity to highlight Bahrain and its local economy.
The forum aims to facilitate the space for participants to benefit from a series of high-level discussions, commentary opportunities, and effective strategies for business development.
The 2017 forum will take place on the 15th of March and will focus on unlocking economic potential through SMEs and is one that shouldn't be missed. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Yasmin Ibrahim.